Module 6, Part 1, Configure Data Permissions. Hello, I'm Peter Myers, the course developer.
And I'm Amit Shuster, Product Manager of Power BI Meta Analytics.
In this video, we arrive at the final stage of the development methodology for embedding Power BI content, now with a focus on configuring data permissions. In this Part 1 video, we will introduce the fundamentals of row-level security, including basic terminology. App developers can restrict access to data by mapping users to roles at runtime. So let's now consider an example. Here's a report and its underlying model data. The model data represents, let's say, global sales. So when user 1 views the report in the app, they see a filtered subset of model data related to who they are. Let me tell you, they're a salesperson responsible for sales in Australia, so they only see Australian sales results.
When user 2 accesses the report, he can only see the data that is relevant for him, for example, data that is only for the Israeli region.
So a single secured master report can be delivered to many users, each with different data access requirements.
There are some things that you need to consider. By default, datasets allow all users to see all data. However, that all data may already be restricted by what the embedding identity account can access. For example, Azure SQL Database might support row-level security by the username that was used to connect to it.
And Amit, it's also possible that if your model is in direct query mode, that it might be querying views, and those views are using where clauses that are filtering by the current username. Implementation is affected by the type of Power BI dataset. So let's now introduce to you the different Power BI dataset types. Row-level security implementation will depend on the type of dataset, whether it represents an internal or external hosted model. There are, in fact, 4 different dataset types that we must consider when enforcing row-level security in our apps. Let's first consider internal hosted. This is where the model is hosted inside the Power BI service. This applies to import or cached models, and direct query or composite models also. Now, it's possible that your models might be external hosted. There are 2 primary products that would support external hosting of models. They are Azure Analysis Services and SQL Server Analysis Services. Note that for SQL Server Analysis Services, a gateway is required for the Power BI service to communicate with that on-prem service.
This diagram shows the different Power BI dataset types that Peter talked about them before. So Power BI can be connected to the internal ones, such as import mode or direct query, and it can also be live connected to Azure Analysis Services. And here you can also be connected in the Azure Analysis Services using import mode or direct query. SQL Server Analysis Services can also be used instead of the Azure Analysis Services.
To better describe how to configure data permissions, let's first introduce some relevant terminology. Terms include roles, rules, and rules we'll talk about static and dynamic roles.
Roles are designed to restrict access to model data by surfacing only specific rows to specific users. Supported by Analysis Services Live Connection, in this case, the roles are defined in the external models, or Power BI Desktop Developed Models, where the roles are defined in the model itself.
Right, and we'll show you how that's done soon.
Roles define one or more rules. And in the Power BI desktop, this can be done by using the Manage Roles and View As buttons at the top ribbon.
Right, and just as a reminder, there's no need to create any roles if all users require access to all of the data. Users can be assigned to more than one role, in which case permission sets are combined. However, it's generally not a good practice to assign users to multiple roles as it can result in unexpected results, so be sure to test thoroughly. We suggest you strive to encapsulate all rules into a single role when possible.
Rules enforce table row filters defined by using DAC expressions. These expressions must evaluate either to true or false. Expression can be static or dynamic. When the expression evaluates as true, the row is retrieved from the dataset. Commonly, rules are assigned to dimension type tables, and relationship filter propagation ensures restricted access to the data in related tables.
So what do we mean by dimension type tables? Well, dimensions are the things, the entities that you're modeling. So the way I think about it is products, places, people, and concepts are your dimension type tables. So this is typically the type of table that you will apply rules to. So let's now see an example of a static rule. Static rules apply filter expressions by using constant values. To retrieve no table rows, you can just set a simple filter of false. In this example, you can see a filter on the region table, filtering the region column by Midwest. That means anyone that is assigned or mapped to this role will only ever see sales for Midwest region. Dynamic rules apply filters based on DAX functions, and there are two functions to consider. The username function that returns the effective username, which in the case of Power BI report embedding is a value that the app passes, and there is the custom data function that can return any string value, but this is applicable only to Azure Analysis Services. So in this example, this rule filters the manager region table. Specifically, it filters the manager column to include only rows where it is equal to the result of the username function. Remember, the value returned by that function is determined by your app. Please note that these functions are not supported for all dataset types, and we'll provide more granular details about different data sources in the next video.
In Power BI Desktop, it is possible to validate permissions by viewing the report using one or more roles. Validation also allows passing in the value for the effective username, but this does not apply to custom data. So in order to do that, just click on the View As button at the top ribbon of the Power BI Desktop, and then make sure the other user is checked. You must also select the roles that you want to enforce. In this example, you can see that we selected the manager role.
Now that you understand the fundamentals of enforcing data permissions on Power BI datasets, in the next video, we're going to explore programmatically how we can enforce these permissions with effective identity.